United. I was born in India, but my heritage is Nepalese. I grew up in a small conservative society. I never expected anything big, like the same rights as boys, or freedom to choose my partner, or to express my desires. But always in my heart, I longed to go where I wouldn't have to worry about people interfering and judging me. From the smallest mundane things to life-changing decisions. That routine interference that says, speak quietly, don't laugh openly, don't leave the house alone, do this, don't do that. At home, I was the equal of my brothers. My bua, daddy, was a liberal person who never discriminated based on gender. He arranged my marriage after I agreed to the match. And I moved from my small community to a big city of Surat. I was excited but nervous about my new family's expectations and about the learning Gujarati language. But soon I had a sweet baby boy, Mihir, to lift my spirits. Then my husband got a job in Canada and I stayed with my in-laws. My husband called pretty much every day and always talked about friendly people and opportunities in Canada. Finally, after 3 years of separation, my visa came through. I was thrilled. But at the same time, I was hit with so much nervousness that I lost faith in myself and shockingly said no. I had never traveled alone before, and I would have my small son with me. And I did not speak a word of English. Thank goodness, my husband did not take no for an answer. He arranged for me to meet Radha Didi, a woman who was making the same trip. And he convinced me all I had to do was simply follow her. So I started packing. I picked a Western dress to travel in. Which shoes should I wear? That was the big decision. Everybody started to give their advice, as they always do. I chose the pair my daddy gave me for my Master of Arts graduation. The first wedge heel sandals I ever owned, with a shiny bronze strap and black soles. Comfortable and easy to slide onto my feet. I knew those shoes would provide the comfort and courage that my daddy gave me. It took 2 days by train to get to Delhi. There I met Radha, the woman I was to follow. And I breathed a sigh of relief. The flight to London was next morning. And all the time, I followed her without questioning. In London, after 4 hours on the tarmac, our flight was cancelled. I had my sleeping son in one hand, carry-on bag in the other. And I couldn't find Radha. Oh, there she was. At immigration, I was frightened, thinking they might send me back. At last, I got through and we reached the hotel in London after midnight. I was exhausted and hungry, and so was Mihir. But there was nothing to eat in the room. I slipped my feet into my sandals, but When I stepped into the corridor, I was bewildered by maze of hallways. Once again, my fear got the best of me and I went back to the room, not daring to fall asleep. Then I heard a knock on the door. It was a woman I'd seen Radha talking to in the airport. She said, "I cannot sleep alone. Can I come in with you?" Since she was Radha's friend, of course I let her in. That night seemed endless. In the morning, Radha Didi came to my room, and when I told her about her friend, she said, "What? I don't know her. I just gave her directions." Good thing she didn't take your passport. That woman was not her friend at all. We finally got to Calgary that day. When I finally saw the smiling face of my husband, I forgot the misadventures of my trip and I was filled with joy. It was pitch black on the highway to Banff. I debated whether I liked this place. That got dark much too soon. Where were almost no people, unlike the streets of India. Getting off the bus, I sank to my knees in snow. I thought I had fallen into a hole. I shook out my sandals and took careful steps into my new home. It has taken me a few years to understand and adapt to this new world. But here I am now, a fearless Canadian girl. Thank you.